marchers have been around for many years. William Playfair, who was a Scottish political economist, is considered by many sources to have created the first bar chart. In the last book he published, he also included a column chart that looked like this. Since then, the visualization of these charts have been improved on by the likes of Edward Tufte, who's known for his concepts of maximizing the data to ink ratio, and phrases like chart junk and let the data speak. You can read all about this in his book, The Visual Display of Quantitative Information. In this video, I'm going to dig deeper into column chart design, and I'm going to share with you 5 tips when it comes to creating the optimal column chart for any of your reports. Now, what I'm going to be showing you here is based on a study conducted at the university where I'm teaching. Link to the full report is below. The point of this study is to test if certain design decisions that you make can influence the effectiveness of your graphs. And here's the best part. They do this by applying eye tracking to make an accurate assessment of what the observer is looking at. Here's what it looks like. The tests are done in special settings. The way it works is you're presented with a question and you need to answer that question by looking at the visualization on the screen while the camera is tracking your eye movements. 2 parameters are measured. 1 is effectiveness, which means did you get the answer right? And the second one is efficiency, which means how fast were you able to respond? Eye tracking is supposed to provide more insight into visual behavior. This is done with the use of scan paths, so how you're moving your eyes, your attention on the screen, and fixations, what you're concentrating on. Here's an example of an actual to budget comparison. Participants were shown this chart and they were asked, what was the variance between actual and budget for the business segment retail? This is an example of the resulting scan path. It shows a complex search pattern and lots of eye movements back and forth. Another group was shown an improved chart and was asked the same question. What was the variance between actual and budget for the business segment retail? And here's an example of the resulting scan path. The eye has much less work to do, which not only is more efficient, which means people were faster in responding, but it also improved the overall effectiveness, which means more people got the right answer. Now let's get into the 5 tips. Number 1, don't use 3D. This is probably a no-brainer, but I found the results interesting. There were 84 participants divided into 3 groups. They were asked 2 questions. Does the actual sales volume exceed the budget in June? And how high is the actual sales volume in June? Here's the 3D version they were shown. For 2D, they were shown different versions like these. For the first question, the study found the 3D graph had an 11% error rate, while the 2D versions had 0. For the second question, where they had to guess the exact number with the 3D version, people estimated either way too high or way too low. And if you're still not convinced, I give you another reason to skip 3D graphs, and that's the response times were 47% longer for 3D than 2D. Number 2, show the values directly above the columns. The study found that when they showed a graph with only label values, the results were better than using only a label axis. People were faster in responding to questions like, how high is the actual sales volume in June? Number 3, align label values vertically if you don't have enough space. With large numbers, we sometimes have the tendency to make them smaller to fit. Instead of putting them horizontally and making them super small, we can put them vertically. Number 4, don't break the axis. This can result in lower effectiveness, which means people misunderstand the message of the graph. Take a look at this. And now this. Do you spot the difference? Number 5, this wasn't directly covered in this study, but it's super important. Don't just give your charts a title, but make them big and meaningful. This is the first place people look at before they move their attention to your chart. They need to know what they're looking for. I hope you found these tips helpful. Let me know in the comments below which ones you're currently using in your reports. If you like this video, give it a like to support my channel And if you'd like to receive my weekly tips, push that subscribe button. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video.